Joining me now is Mike Papantonio, Ring of Fire radio host. Mike, there is a geopolitical play here now with Keystone. If the president approves Keystone, it's going to, I think as far as Putin is concerned, it's going to make it look like we're throwing more oil on the market to make their economies worse. What do you make of this play?
Well, there's another factor in this. I mean, from an American consumer standpoint, cheaper fuel is spectacular. It's easy for the other side to talk about that. Cheaper fuel, cheaper fuel, cheaper fuel. Cheaper, you know, when it's cheaper, it obviously means disposable income to buy big ticket consumer items. Because of that, consumer goods need to be manufactured and more jobs are created. But really, there's a bigger problem here. You can't really miss the fact that there's another side to this. And this is what the discussion needs to be. The Bank of England has what they call the Financial Policy Committee. For decades, Ed, that group has monitored both positive and negative systemic changes in the world economy. I think they got it right when they pointed out that there's significant geopolitical risk to what's going on with falling oil prices. The Keystone, I'm not sure it's going to affect anything, but the argument is it looks like it's putting more pressure on oil prices. Depressed oil prices definitely cause problems for countries like Iran, for example. It's losing more than $1 billion per month because of the fall. It's a fall to the point, Ed, to the chief economist, one of the very chief economists in that area of the world, admits that Iran needs money desperately. Russia, as you just talked about, is experiencing a triple slap in the face between international sanctions to the Ukraine, rubles falling because of wealth gaps, and now they have what used to be oil that they sold for $115 a barrel reduced to $60. Well, so take that and add Keystone to it, and this is a big pressure area from geopolitics. It's not just domestic issues anymore.
Well, the Republicans wanted to drill, baby, drill. Well, we've been drilling. Now there's a world effect here. But also our consumption is different now because of all of the green technology and the effort that we've made as a society to do some things differently. But, you know, this is hitting the Bakken shale, too. There's a scale back in the economy in the northern tier right now because of these oil prices as well. It's not as if that, you know, they're taking the profits through the roof right now. The big play here, though, this is a real opportunity for foreign policy, though, isn't it?
It's absolutely a great opportunity for foreign policy. Look, we ought to pay attention to foreign policy. There's a great domino effect. For example, Venezuela, largest oil reserves in the world. 95% of their export money comes from oil reserves that they ship out of the country. How do they repay massive debts to Europe and Asia, the banks that help finance business and government in Venezuela? That has an effect on domestic
policy.
Absolutely. So look, is it a good thing that Russia experiences severe financial crisis because of the oil issue?
Yeah.
No, it's not.
But
because they stop investing in European business?
The big story in 2014 has been the American economy. All the obstruction has not stopped the ingenuity, the entrepreneurship, and everything else, the heart and the spirit of the American people. Look at the stock market. Look at the number of people that have gotten jobs back. Look at the corporate profits that have been going. What we need now is investment. There's more opportunity if we invest in our infrastructure. We right now are the guiding light of the world economy right now, and this is a real opportunity for America to move forward with these prices where they are. Mike, great to have you with us. Mike Papantonio, America's lawyer here.
Thank you,
on The Ed Show.